Come back soon, Walker. Standby mode initiated.
I am Garcia the Gregarious, trader and traveler, merchant of fine merchandise? Pray tell, who may you be?
I may be Walker. Are we really speaking like this?
Well, of course. That is how we show our caliber. And that is why you want to trade with only me. My wares are quite superb.
Let me then scrutinize your vendables.
Oh, with pleasure. I know.
System activating.
Century.
100% integrity. Energy shields detected. Try alternative weapon. Integrity restored.
I came looking.
Welcome, Ranger. Welcome. It's been too long since I played host to one of your kind.
Dr. Anton Kvasir, genius scientist with a shifty past. Original Arcist, pre-Apophis. They say he worked for the Authority and helped create their mutant soldiers. Then he turned on his masters, joined the cause, fought alongside my folks in the Authority War. Not sure how I feel about mad scientists at this point, but I do need his help. It's an impressive setup, Dr. Kvasir?
Kvasir, yes, my lab suffices. Legs. My research used to be more mechanically inclined. But over time, the machines, it turns out, fail. I prefer to rely now on genetically engineered solutions, simply because they can heal.
Makes sense, I guess.
I hope you don't mind. Walker, yes? I put your scan through my ARC mainframe. I know you now. Your parents. Such a tragedy when they were lost. But Arvina Prowley took you in, no?
She did. As if I was her own. But they killed her. They destroyed everything I ever knew.
Dead? Oh, no. She was formidable. I was always hoping to, but alas, no.
It was a massacre, an unstoppable force. Mutants, a new kind of creature. All tech and armor and guns, and huge, taller than any building. And they were led by a man, General Martin Cross.
Oh, he is back then. It was to be expected. Him and his lapdog scientist, Dr. Bendros, were always hard at work on their longevity project. But you see, for that problem, I just might have some solutions.
Solutions. I've got one for you. Project Dagger.
Ah, you know. Yes, of course you do. Prowley must have told you already. It will be easy for me to do my part. The project was always equal parts action and science. Come back in about 6 years or so. Then I will have concocted the nanotrite reprogramming agent, or serum, as I prefer to call it.
Whoa, did you just say 6 years?
Yes, thereabouts. The science cannot be rushed. Yes, it can. Better computing power. But alas, my lab is old and tired. Only the elusive Eco-15 still in orbit could provide the computing power to speed up this process.
The Eco-Pod's still in orbit? Been hearing about that since I was a kid.
Yes, it was a miscalculation. Remained on the firmament as the others came tumbling down. If Eco-15 was to be forced down, I could tap into the processing power of that ancient supercomputer. Think of it, to siphon that brute computing force into my poor old laboratory.
Is there any way to force it down?
Yes. It can be done from the Eden Space Center.
Then I'll do it.
Yes.
Wait a minute. You knew I was going to volunteer to do it, didn't you?
Yes.
Systems regenerating. Systems. Systems fully.
Thank you.
Come back soon, Walker.
Approaching the Eden Space Center.
Ah, yes. It might be overrum by road scum, come to think of it. But that will be no problem for a ranger. No problem at all.
Standby mode initiated. Destination reached. Weapon overheated.
Yeah.
Doctor, I made it to the Space Center. It's in ruins, and like you said, overrun by thugs.
It should pose no problem to you. And as for Eden, well, it was built to withstand anything. Let us get you proper access. Press palm to hand scan in the reception desk.
Well, look at that.
Excellent. Now, allow me to give you full access.
Hey, Doc, better hurry up. Road goons got the scent.
Wait, hold. I have it almost. I almost had it. Just give me a few more minutes. System, this, even for me. I am just about to break on through.
Fuck off!